Hi everyone, welcome to First Cut Reviews. Today I'm going to be reviewing Antman and the Wasp.
Hey, what'd I miss?
We were just tiny!
Peyton Reed's new outing, Antman and the Wasp, has its minute moments of charm, but what lacks is lair, craft and excitement, a must for this genre. Handling a wafer-thin plot like this is tricky. Peyton tries to uplift the game, but unfortunately, he isn't able to infuse a level of thrill to his rather one-toned screenplay. Ant-Man opens up fresh. Our hero's under house arrest because of what happened in Germany with Captain America, and now all the fun he has is to play with his daughter within those four walls.
So, how long have you been Ant-Man again?
Sitting within his bathtub, he suddenly begins to make connections with the quantum realm and realizes that he might actually be able to rescue Hank's lost wife, who's stuck somewhere there. How Hope, Hank's daughter, and our Ant-Man team up to carry this out is what lies ahead.
I wish I could fight bad guys like you.
I seem to mess it up almost every time.
The film opens on a rather intriguing note. The conversation between Hope and her father will spark some suspense to see where this goes. And truly, a hero struggling under house arrest is something which itself sounds quite hilarious. But soon after, the script isn't able to hold well enough. Majorly because Peyton punches in too many subplots that serve nothing more than distractions. About half of the film just passes by juggling around an asset from one gang to another, which truly gets tiresome after a point. The writers try to pepper the boring and repetitive ongoings with some pleasant humor, but that too lands well only remotely. There's a running joke on a truth serum which did keep me happy and giggling. The action, beautifully choreographed, will take your senses on a rush, but alas, there's little to excite beyond. There's also a lot of talking about quantum realms, existence and disappearing, molecular disintegration, etc., which brings a good realistic touch. But beyond a point, it just goes on, and what lacks is exhilarating material.
You opened up the quantum realm. That's when this crazy creepy ghost who like walks through walls and stuff stole your tech.
Our villain here too, the ghost, isn't just evil enough. You won't for once root for our hero or hate the ghost. And that itself is a failure. The background music has an old school feel to it, but some variety would have surely served justice. The climax too follows the very same tone of the film. Bland and surface level. The post-credit surely has a surprise wrapped well. But I left wondering whether a film was really needed to make sense of that one scene to carry the Marvel Universe forward. Paul Rudd is sincere. He has an inherent charm in the way he delivers, and he is one you can forever rely on. Michael Douglas, as Hank, is nuanced, but his character doesn't explore many shades. Evangeline Lilly, as Hope, is gorgeous and delivers well what she's given. Hannah John, though, playing the ghost, just isn't able to bring herself enough pain. She remains pretty forgettable. With Ant-Man and the Wasp, Marvel yet again tries something new, but all it serves is a cold plate with a fun dessert at the end. This one had potential, but the sole motive to reach that post-credit scene dilutes the essence this film deserved. I'm going with 2.5 out of 5 for Ant-Man and the Wasp.
Ant-Man and the Wasp teaming up.
Follow my lead.
I was excited in parts, but towards the middle, I almost took a nap.